Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by this some have entertained angels without knowing it. Hebrews 13:2. Welcome aboard, gentlemen. I am Captain Rosefeld. Tell me, who is in charge of all these warriors? Please step up. Your name, young man?
I'm Sergeant.
I have no interest in your rank. Your name? Who are you?
Mitchell.
Mitchell, huh? Yes, Mitchell. A name with many meanings. For some, the meaning is a gift from God. For others, who is like God? Which one are you, Mitchell? Are you a gift from God sent to save us? Or perhaps you are God himself come to doom our worthless lives?
Perhaps.
He's cursed.
Cursed, eh? What kind of curse is this?
Nothing but some bullshit.
Whoever is at the top of his command dies. Colonel Q, Sergeant Harvey, they're all dead. But whatever happens, he lives.
It's just a coincidence. There's no such thing as a curse.
We'll see about that, Sergeant. You and your men from now on are under my command. Welcome to Avalon Vale, and welcome to the crew.
Okay. I don't see exactly how this ties into the cutscene. All of a sudden we've got fucking exploders. And the exploders don't seem to give a shit about anything. They just fly on past. That's nice. Oh, it really is like I'm playing Gary's Mod. Everybody's just standing around. Probably not a good place to say, but I'm guessing this is like before. Everybody just stands around. You have to run up somewhere and to trigger some shit. Or there's an invisible wall. Oh, there's... Yeah, all of a sudden they have AI tracking and try to kill you. That was not there before. This thing's barely functioning right now. Oh, you get it? The G-Man is a secret thing there. Whoa. That taking 40 mils to the face and just shrug it off. It's fucking nothing. Shooting water balloons at him. What the hell was that? So it's just wave defense. This entire level is wave defense. You fucking stand here. With one health. Now it actually looks like the guy's like, "Ooh, he's cursed!" Doesn't exist. Well, this is exciting. This is great. Oh no, now there's a dropship. Oh no. No, that guy's right here. Is this the guy from the plant? The guy with the drunk voice acting and the fucking plant that disappeared as soon as you left it? Okay, do I run up now? Do I run up and do something now? Does anything exist, or do I just stand there and wait for this scripted event? Oh, you run up and die. No Vortigaunt. Oh, there it is. There's one. I don't know what the hell they're doing with this fog, but it clearly doesn't work. I guess there are other soldiers further ahead. If I just stand here, the Vortigaunts come closer. Did it decide that you didn't want to send up the new ones? I certainly have to. Nope. Don't exist until I take a step forward and get into their line of fire. Good fucking god. Fuck this fog effect. Yeah, you better run back to reload. This was exciting. No medkits. Nothing to heal with.
Looks like you're the captain now. Captain Mitchell.
It's been 3 years since the Seven-Hour War. There are no more countries, only territories where they once were. All the governments having been replaced by one, the Combine. The alien Combine Empire had enslaved humanity, put in place a puppet leader, Dr. Breen, and then started siphoning the Earth's resources. Shorelines fell, exposing the seabed. The remaining humans were gathered in cities, the world outside of such areas filled with wildlife native to other worlds, making the exteriors of cities dangerous. Facilities like Nova Prospect were opened, their goal being to modify humans, erase their memories, and assimilate them into their armies. While some humans were conscripted into service, others volunteered, either for preferred treatment, better living conditions, or personal reasons. Thus, the Civil Protection Branch of the Combine Overwatch was formed, Earth's so-called police. The Combine Overwatch was an impressive force to be reckoned with, but an exploit was found. They had immense power over the air, and even more on land, but they lacked naval capabilities due to their overall goal of draining that resource. Until that happened, we needed a way to defend our ship from their air superiority, and for that, we needed to go to City 9, otherwise known as New Alaska.
Did it crash? No, it's another stupidly long loading screen. All right, now we got two-dimensional snow. No inventory. Cool. What kind of overly flashy animation was that? Okay, I'm allowed to have the machete now. Clearly a 1911 and a flare. Not allowed to sprint, though. Looks like we're using a little color correction magic. I could see where I was going. And it got a little closer and it got darker. Oh, great. That was my only flare, and that's actually a dead end. Kind of guiding myself by looking at the color banding on my monitor. I can very vaguely make out some tunnels. Or at least it kind of looks like it. A little trippy. If I were drinking, this would probably look really fucked up. Okay. Aim down the sights and you teleport to the exit, apparently. Oh, and now it's snowing again. But I make a hard save. We got a big expanse of fancy looking mountains, and we've got a pretty prototypical stereotypical 12 different kinds of typical fucking Source Engine box house. With no detail. Just a fucking box. A rectangle. Well, we got the Mafia. Yeah, Mitchell, you gotta put ammo in. Alright, we got a fucking... What is this, a car? Carabiner 98. An interesting thing to see in Alaska. Let's see, I can take that door, or I can... do that and dig this door. What's the point of this building? Am Well, I'll say this much. It's not exactly possible to get lost. Not in this place. You don't have to worry about them being incompetent and not knowing, you know, how to tell you where you need to go.